Hey guys, it's me. If you've noticed things have been a little too quiet recently, congrats, you're very observant. But seriously, April and May are going to be a busy month for me due to me finally moving to a new house where I'll get to have a little more peace and quiet to record things. So for now, just bear with me and hope you're enjoying the Resident Evil 7 run if you're watching it. Even if I think it's time to retire the laptop mic for real this time. Without further ado, enjoy the amiibo fight. Alright, now we move on to the sixth match of the round one with Lucina versus Peach. I feel really bad about this because I recorded this before and the audio wasn't recording at the time and it was funny! That makes me so mad! So here I am doing a redo. Peach with the back throw. Not quite. The Peach's at 57%. Not quite. Man, can you tell I've been out of practice on this one? It's been a while since I've had to record one of these. I'm sorry. Oh, nice up smash from Lucina with Peach at 94. Oh, nice forward air from Lucina. Peach now at 110%. Oh, now Lucina's 110%. But that auto recovery is bringing her damage down quite a little bit, little by little, but not like seems to make a difference. There's the shield wrap, shield smash, and doesn't really capitalize. Come on, Lucina, I taught you better than that. Yeah, see, that's what happens when you don't punish. You get knocked out. This is why you punish when you break a shield. Lucina, come on, I taught you better than that. Peach doing the clobbering big time here, even though she has 156%. Literally any strong hit will knock Peach out, but it doesn't look like... Oh, look! Almost at speak of the devil. Literally any big hit is going to be able to knock Peach out, but if it connects... And it looks like Peach is not going to let her do that. Oh, nice hit, nice sneak attack with the vegetable from Peach. But now that Lucina has double damage enabled, she needs one good smack, and Peach is going to be out, and there it is! Just like I said, one good hit would knock her out. See, even if you have like over 50, even though you have over 50 in, in defense, does not going to matter at all. Not at all. If your damage is at 200, you're out of here. Oh, nice forward air from Peach, sending Lucina off the stage. Not sure how I feel about that, the way she recovers, though. Because you recover like that, you're pretty much baiting yourself to get meteored pretty easily. Yeah. Excuse me, I'm still trying to get over a stomach bug I had earlier this month. earlier in the week, anyway. Yeah. It's hard for me to commentate because I haven't done this for so long. Oh, nice sneak attack from Lucina there. Also, for the Tails fans out there, yes, I named them after Tails characters. Just imagine how that would go. I don't really think you have to imagine that very well. Considering Lucina is not even close to being her tail self. Oh, one up smash from Peach later, and Lucina's out of there. I don't think it's very fun for the opposing player, Peach. I'm just saying. Moving on. Now we're gonna be moving on to the second round of this round here, and I would have used Final Fantasy music if I didn't get copyrighted. That's always a bummer, isn't it? Yeah, that's real smart for you, Lucina. Nice job. Most of the matches I do, I usually just watch them blind. I know who wins, I just don't know, I just never know who actually get, how they get there. And that's what surprises me the most about these. Like, I don't actually watch the match themselves. I know who wins, obviously. But I want to know how they get there. Like, in mid-recording, so that the shock value is real. I know it doesn't sound convincing, but I swear that's the truth. Also, I still find it hard to believe that Final Fantasy VII, the one console game that was not on Nintendo system, is on Smash Brothers. And I have a pretty good reason why, too. That's because Square's been like, hey, you want a rhythm game on your 3DS? We got you covered. Here, have the ant rhythm. That was a big star on that. No, it wasn't because of Kingdom Hearts. Stop asking. let's focus on the match, please. Let's focus on the match, shall we? Oh, nice counter from Peach there. Putting Lucina to 108%. Did I say 80? 106. It was 108 before. That auto heal, bringing her down little by little. Not sure if it's making quite a difference, but doesn't really matter because she knocked out Peach like nothing. Now Peach is one stock short with Lucina at comfy 96. But slowly but surely, that's going down with her auto recovery. Nice counter from Lucina there. Peach now at 57%. This battle took a turn real fast, didn't it? Now it's become a dominating match with Lucina as the dominator. Now they seem to be more comfy with hopping around rather than actually fighting. Peach now at 102%. This might not end well for the princess here. Well, I guess technically they're both princesses, but anyway, let's just ignore that detail. Man, they just love jumping around, don't they? It's like, tra-la-la-la! Nice comboing from Peach there. Yeah, come on, Peach, at least knock out one stock. Don't just stare at her, stop it. Oh, nice quick counter from Lucina there. Nice forward air from Lucina. She needs one good strong hit to actually end this. It doesn't look... Oh, there it is! About time, too, because I ran out of things to say. Oh, man. Oh, how fitting. The ending title. How fitting that her end quote is that. And not anything else. As she moves on to the third and final matchup for round 6. And to decide it, we're at the gym. At the Wii Fit Gymnasium. Because I can't think of any other place to do a finale match than the gym. And there's Peach at 108%. So many smashes. Oh, broke her shield. Oh, nice forward air from Peach there. Sending Lucina to 59%. Remember, folks, this match is for all the grapes. All them grapes. I just hope we don't have another derp moment. Who am I kidding? I already know how this ends. Oh, nice grab from Lucina there with a back throw. Oh, nice forward smash from Lucina, but not quite gonna be killing Peach just yet. She seems to be juggling her quite a bit there. She really loves that down B special, but Peach is quick to counter. They both need just one good hit to knock each other out. Well, mainly Peach doesn't. Mainly Peach needs one good hit to knock herself out. But now Lucina has that double damage, which means literally any good hit will knock out Peach. Well, she can actually get there first. Oh, there's a good hit, and now goes Peach. But now Lucina sitting at 150%, literally Peach can literally do the exact same thing to her as she did. But they gotta be very careful. Because that auto heal's not gonna be able to do much. Oh. For a second, I thought Peach had the stitch face. I would have been like, oh, jeez, that's gonna hurt. Those not familiar with Smash, the stitch face is pretty much a Falcon Punch. And that hurts. A lot. Ooh, nice little neutral B from Lucina. Ooh, actually managed to get her out of the shielding? Or she blocked it. She probably blocked it. Oh, there's the forward. There's the up smash, and Lucina takes it. What a comeback. What a comeback. Like, she went through both rounds, did not even lose a single stock. Go, Lucina. I have no idea why I named you after a Tales of the Abyss character, considering you're not even close to being that. Oh, well, whatever. I don't know what my brain was thinking. Shut up, and I'll get to you. Next up, we have Dr. Falcon versus Dr. Mario. See if this... I just realized I said Dr. Falcon. Dr. Falcon, what do you prescribe? I'm gonna go lay down. See you guys for Captain Falcon versus Dr. Mario.